You've studied for the MCAT before, but it didn't go as planned. And so you're starting over with a clean slate. Do you quickly review content so that you can move on to practice? Well, what if you missed something? Or do you start over, guarantee that you're going to cover everything, but in the process waste so much time? In this Layer for Slide video, I'm going to show you how you can get the benefit of starting over, but also get the benefit of the speedy review. Why would you even want to start from scratch? In my program, the MCAT Study Hall, I work with a lot of students who have studied before, but for whatever reason, it didn't work out, and they come to me to have a strategy to do it right so that it becomes one and done. If you're like my students, maybe the last time you studied, you just read through your books, but you didn't do enough practice to really drill it in, or you read through the books but didn't actually understand, or maybe you did study the right way, but it was so long ago, and then something happened that chances are you forgot a decent amount. But because you want to get it right this time, by going back, that means having to redo every subject, every chapter, every topic, everything, and that could take
forever.
Don't get me wrong, that is the ideal scenario, but do you really have that kind of time? On the other hand, if you just quickly review without starting over, yeah, you're going to refresh a lot of the information, but what about those things you didn't understand? Or what if you just pick and choose the topics you think you need to review and wind up missing something so critical that it costs you a point on your MCAT in each section? Let's agree that the only way to make sure you covered everything is to cover everything, but in a way that doesn't waste so much time and helps you easily identify what you need to focus on in detail and what you can go through quickly. If this sounds like a plan, make sure you give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, and hit that bell notification icon so you don't miss out on any new videos, and let's see how to do it. Back in my EMT days, when we brought a patient to the emergency room, we would check in with the triage nurse. We gave the triage nurse an overview of the patient's situation, and they would decide where the patient goes. For the guy who called the ambulance a full week after falling down and bumping his head, he got sent to the waiting room. But the kid who had an allergic reaction and wasn't breathing, only kept alive because I was actively squeezing air into his lungs, he was so high priority that the ER staff met us at the ambulance and he was already in the resuscitation room by the time I finished giving the triage nurse my report. No, we're not going to resuscitate your books, though I'm sure you just like to go, pfft. Well, okay, maybe, but here's how. Go in with the intention of redoing everything from scratch, but you're going to triage each chapter as follows. Using your book as a guide, open to the chapter summary, look at the subtopics, and ask yourself, how do I feel about this particular topic? Pretty good, kinda sorta, not really. If you feel pretty good about a topic, then the review is just a formality. As you quickly fly through the book, I want you to think, got this, got this, got this. And if you get to something where you think, I don't got this, well, great. That's exactly why you're reading everything. This is where you slow down, read it carefully, maybe even find a supplemental video to make sure you really understand, and then you resume flying through the rest of the chapter. It's not enough to think you know it. You have to prove it to yourself by doing the practice questions. If you score at least 70%, review to make sure you understand what you missed and keep going. But if you score less than 70%, I hate to break it to you, you don't got this. You have to go back and redo the chapter, then redo the questions to make sure you get them right. I discussed the 70% rule on my website link below. This is the material that you kind of sort of know. You're not ready to do a quick fly through because you're not as comfortable with it, but at the same time, you don't want to go through it in detail because it's not as unfamiliar to you. Depending on the topic, you have a couple of options. If you're an audiovisual learner like myself and prefer to learn from video, then maybe watch the videos at 1.3 or 1.5 speed with the same thought in mind. Do I understand this? Do I know this? Am I good to move on? But the video will provide you with the extra explanations to make sure that you really understand. And hey, if you get to a topic that you realize you don't know, slow down. Play the video at regular speed, pause, let it sink in, rewatch if needed, then go back to the chapter and do the same thing as before. Skim, 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 thinking, I got this, I got this, I got this, and slow down for anything that you're not comfortable with. And again, don't skip the questions. Make sure you know the information by proving to yourself that you can score at least 70%. Number three is why we did this method. This is why you went through everything quickly so that you have the time to slow down for the topics you know you need to work on. For a lot of students, it's that one topic that they never understood or they always struggled with. Think fluids or optics in physics, spectroscopy in organic chemistry. As I explain in my How to Study the MCAT Sciences post linked below, this is where you need to take the time. Start with a video to learn, watch twice if you need to, find other videos if you need to, do whatever it takes to understand, then go through the book. Do that carefully, and of course, practice questions. If you're starting fresh with MCAT content, does this feel like a less wasteful approach to make sure that you get through everything in time? Let me know in the comments below. Using this method, how do you know that you're on track? How do you know that you're making the progress that you need to? This is exactly what I show you in this video on my website
at layoffresci.com/phases. Again, that's layoffresci.com/phases.